Hi children, today we will start the new chapter, chapter 4. Chapter 4 is about factors. So here I have a question. We need to find factors of 8. So already in class 4 you have learned about what is factors. So to find what are the factors of 8, we must check what are the numbers we can multiply and get 8 as product. So one by one you can check the tables, I said. Okay, so first we start from the ones table. So ones table, 1 into 8, we get 8. So that multiplication statement I have written here. When we check table of 2, it is 2 into 4 that we get 8. And when we see third table, we don't have 8 in third table. And 4, 5, etc. if you go, there is no 8 in the 8th table. Sorry, there is no 8. But in the 8th table, we have 1 into 8. That is already we have written here. Okay, so that we can. So 8 into 1 and 1 into 8 is 8. So one statement is enough. Okay. So these are the numbers we can multiply and get the product as 8. So here we can say that the factors of 8 is equal to 1, 8. 1, 8. Then 2, 4. 2 and 4. So these are the factors of 8. So what do we mean by factors? The numbers that are multiplied to find a product are called its factors. That is, here to get 8, these are the numbers we multiplied. So these are called as the factors of 8. What are the numbers we multiply to get the product? That numbers are called as factors. So factor of 8 is 1, 8, 2 and 4. Let us see few more examples. Now factors of 10. So as I said, start from first table. So we get 1 into 10 is 10. Then next 2's table we have 2 into 5 is equal to 10. Third table we don't have. Then 4, 5. Fifth table also we have, that is 5 into 2. That is already we have written. As well as 10th table also we have 10 into 1. That also I have written here, 1 into 2. So that cases you can write one statement, that is enough. Okay, so here once you find out what are the factors of 10, we can say 1, 2, 5 and 10. So these are the factors of 10, what we can say. Then next we have factors of 24. So to find factors of 24, I must start from the table of 1. Just go through that. 1 into 24 is 24. Then 2's table, when we go, 2 into 12. So we will only just check up to 10, but go beyond that also. 11, 12, 13 also, just check in the 2's table. Okay. Then 2 into 12 is equal to 24. Then third table, when we go, we find that 3 8's are 24. So that I have written. Then fourth table, when we go, it's 4 into 6, 24. Fifth table, when I go, it is more than 24. It is 25. So we can't take fifth table. Then sixth table already I have written over here. Seventh table we don't have. Eighth table already I have written here. That's all. So just check the tables and find the factors like this. And we have division methods also, that I will discuss later on. And we also can use divisibility rules to find the factors easily, that we will discuss later on. So this is one simple method we can use to find the factors. Okay, so what we can say here, the factors of 24 as 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 24, 12, 8, 6. So I have listed out all the factors of 24 over here. So this is all about factors. And there are few properties of factors when we consider this. Look at the first factor, property. 1 is a factor of every number. That is, when you consider these cases, you can see everywhere 1 will be there in the factor list. So if you take in any number, 1 will be there one as one of the factor of any number. So if you consider any number, 1 will be the factor of every number. And it is also the smallest number. That is, when you check the list of factors of any number, 1 will be the smallest factor for every number. Here if you check the 24's case, 1 is the smallest factor of 24. Again, when you check the 10's case, 1 is the smallest factor over here also. So that is what they mean over here. Then every number is a factor of itself. Same way, consider the cases of factors of 24. We can see 24 as a factor over here. Consider the factors of 10. What happens? 10 is also a factor of 10. So if you consider any number, that number is also one of the factor of the given number. And that will be the greatest factor of that number. That is, when we consider 24, 24 will not have any factor which is bigger than 24. And when you consider factors of 10, 10 will not have a factor which is bigger than 10. So that number, or suppose if any number is given, that number will be the greatest factor of that number. Then every number has at least two factors, that is one and that number itself. For example, if I take 5, what are the factors of 5? Yeah, it comes only in the ones table and fives table, that is 1 into 5. So what we can say, factors of 5s are 1 and 5, correct? 17, when you take, in which table we get 17? Only in 17's table or 1's table, right? So 1 into 17, these are the factors, that is 1 and 17 are factors of 17. So at least two factors a number will have here, at least 1 and 5, that number itself. So every number if you take, it will be, factors will be more than 2 or at least two. So some cases it will be 1 and that number itself. About that we will detail learn in the coming up videos. So this is for today. So these are your homework questions. You have to find the factors of the given numbers 42, 30, 81, 72 and 49. You have to list out all the factors of these numbers, as well as whatever I have written over here. For example, from here, chapter 4 factors and whatever I have written till the C question, this page and this one. Up to this, you have to copy down into your classwork, as well as your homework also, you have to write it in your classwork. It's just recalling of factors what you have learned in class 4. Thank you, children.